get drafted. The feeling, man, crazy. Craziest part is I was actually in my graduation line.
J Boy, aka Bossman, fourth round, Oakland A, you know what I'm saying? Keep it solid, it's the real estate.
Bonding over drugs and pain, dirty sprites, yeah. My dog was one of a kind, I know your type rare. I know life is a bitch and she don't fight fair. How the fuck I wake up from a dream to a nightmare? Left us behind, you seen that light glare. I know you walking up to heaven on them white stairs. Why I can't just pull up to your crib and see you right there? Nobody love you till you dead, that's when they might care. Let's just be friends before we rush into a label. Wanna know if you really for me, girl, what's your angle? It's only for the better if I'm trying to change you. Loving me ain't easy, if you leave, I don't blame you. Trauma got me fucked up, so I'm mentally unstable. I got wrapped up in my emotions, now I'm tangled. Deep in my thoughts and overthinking can get painful. Watch how I move, on wrong decision can be fatal. Hidden messages, conversations with my angels. Just walk with me and you will see I'm trying to save you. Most times I'm by myself, I'm still confused from betrayal. From rats to riches, still hot, I'm just on phase two. Bonding over drugs and pain, dirty sprites. My dog was one of a kind, I know your type red.
BJ Boyd from Palo Alto, California, former Oakland Athletic. Here's my story. Man, grew up in Palo Alto, man, great place to be. Great opportunities out there. As a youngster, I started in East Palo Alto Little League for a second, played there for a little bit, moved over to Palo Alto, met this guy named Mike Piha. Man, it was a true blessing. He put me on his team in Little League called Into Change. Played there for several years. I didn't get to play my 12-year-old year, so I was 12 years old playing Pony. Still young, man. I was still young, still trying to learn. I always had my Uncle Dave Jefferson in my ear, all the time keeping me right. He was a former baseball player too. Drafted out of high school out of Palo Alto, same as me. So he kind of pushed me, took me everywhere. I got an opportunity to play with a guy named Rob Bruno in NorCal baseball. One of the best things I've ever done. I felt like when I got with that team, it was sky's the limit. I had guys on my team, J.R. Davis, Willie Calhoun. It was like two players just like me, 1, 2, 3 in the batting order. Bunch of other guys, you know what I'm saying? Guys like CC Sabathia coming through there, Jimmy Rollins, Dontrell Willis, Brandon Crawford, Jock Peterson, etc. And going into high school. Started out a place called St. Francis High School in Mountain View, California. Private school. I tried it out my freshman year. I had a good time. A good friend of mine, Jordan P. Hall, was there. And his dad got me to go there to try it. He said there's great opportunity there, which there was. I'm thankful for that. So I get there, I play football, I play basketball. I don't end up making the baseball team. For some reason, I guess my grades weren't right, so I had to go to summer school and get it together. So I went to summer school. After that, I came back into football season after a sophomore, to be a sophomore. Thought I should have been on varsity with my ability, and they kind of didn't really show me any love, and I felt like I came to the school to play sports. So didn't feel love, didn't feel like it was a place to call home anymore. I felt like if these aren't my people, this is not where I'm from, why am I here? So I took upon myself to go back to Palo Alto, walk from Mountain View all the way to Palo Alto just to get back home where I feel loved. So I had to sit out my whole sophomore year because of I'm leaving a private school to a public. So didn't get to play my baseball season as a sophomore. So my sophomore year sitting out, major league ball player Jock Peterson is playing at my high school and I'm not playing sophomore year. I felt like he had a lot of scouts on him and stuff at the time, which would have been a great opportunity for me. While sitting there, I used to go to the games and I'll watch from a distance and I'll watch everything he did. I'll watch everything, what he brought to the game, and I'll try to copy it when I go play. Junior year, fresh back to play sports. I played football, running back. We went all the way to state. Devontae Adams, shout out to him, NFL Green Bay receiver. The truth. Junior year, man, craziest thing about it is My junior year baseball team was the same T-ball team that we had. We ended up winning the whole conference, state championship. I go to the Bay Area World Series in Santa Clara University. Shout out to Ben Snyder for bringing me along. Crazy story, I actually went to go watch Ben, and I had an extra pair of cleats in the car. And he told me to put my cleats on and go stretch and run the 60. And I forgot what I ran the 60 in, but I know it was like a 6'4 below. And right there, I made the Bay Area World Series team from Santa Clara, the Peninsula team. Draft process. My uncle Dave Jefferson taking me everywhere, flying to Seattle, trying to get exposure. I wasn't a perfect game kid. I wasn't an athletic kid. So my uncle has a program called Swagger Athletics. Crazy story. My uncle needed a player at the time, and I was sitting at home off season. Didn't really want to be in baseball. Kind of was focused on football at the time. And we're arguing. And he was always telling me, he'd always get me mad and tell me, I'm weak, you ain't this, you ain't that, you ain't gonna be there if you don't get up. So, man, I proved him wrong. I got up, my first AB during the game, home run. What do you think I do? Pack my stuff and get up and go home. Just to let him know that I was not playing, that I'm serious in this game. Get drafted. The feeling, man, crazy. Craziest part is I was actually in my graduation line and everybody was on their phones. So when I got announced, the guy said, now batting, BJ Boyd. And the whole crowd went wild for me on my graduation day. 18 years old, getting drafted. They sent me to Arizona rookie ball. Man, I swear to God, when I got drafted, I thought I was going straight to Oakland. Didn't really understand the minor league, so started in Arizona rookie ball. Man, that was baseball every day. Get up at 11, you got to practice before you play the game. Serious crunch time. First year in rookie ball, hit 300. Was juiced. Got to the off season. Grandpa had passed away. Hit me hard. I kind of didn't really focus on baseball at that point anymore. I kind of just wanted to hang out and be home because I felt like every time I was gone, something would happen to a family member. So I was kind of always homesick. Kept playing just so I could play throughout my contract, but wasn't sure if I really wanted to go back. So I got back, went to short season. Did well. I made the All-Star team in short season. Never really got moved up. Thought I did well to get moved up, but had to stay in Vermont the whole year. I went to Low A in Beloit, Wisconsin. The coldest place I've ever been in my life. Shaking trying to play baseball. Not it. I got to High A. That's home, Stockton, California. Did well. Always had people there to support me. I loved it there. To me, Stockton was the big leagues. I'm not even gonna lie to you. I felt like I was loved, I felt home. After that, I went to Midland, Texas. I hit like 323, was another All-Star. I was the MVP of the All-Star game. Never really got moved up. Went to AAA the next year. In my eyes, I was never supposed to make it to AAA, but somebody got hurt and somebody got traded, so they gave me a spot. I felt like with my spot, I did well. Didn't get the opportunity to get to the big leagues. So I played out my 7 years of my contract and kind of just said, I want to go back to school and figure out my family situation. Leaving pro ball, I have money for school. So I enrolled at CSM, College of San Mateo. Felt like I always needed some structure. Shout out to Tim Tullett, great coach over there. My wife was pregnant at the time, so we had to move closer back home. So I decided to transfer to Foothill. Shout out to Kelly Edwards for allowing me to come there. We actually had a great season, went 10-1, changed the school history. It felt good to be a part of the team because I'm not used to losing anyway. 7 years after pro ball going back to football, I'm not gonna lie to you. I was ready, but I was still iffy about getting hurt because I always still had love for baseball. At the time when I left, there was really no love for it at the time. It was like, I need to get my priorities straight and think about my family. So playing football, I was always, I wouldn't say suspect in the game, but I knew what I can do. If you watch the tape, the highlights will show you. I still got it. But I decided to sign back and play baseball in Mexico. I feel like my family and I, we love to vacation. We love to go see things, so I think like this is a great experience for us. Man, sitting at home, debating. I'm on the phone with J.R. Davis and Willie Calhoun. We on three-way. And they telling me to get back up and go play baseball. Like, you was right there. You can, you know what I'm saying? You still got it. I'm sitting there laughing, 2 seconds later, an old coach of mine, Lloyd Turner, calls me. Tells me, man, you need to get up and go play. So I get up and go play. I had a friend named John Velasco from De La Salle. He had called me, said, I'm headed to Mexico. I can get you a job. So I hit him up. He got me the contacts, got me ready. I jumped in the cage. Haven't missed a beat. During the off season right now, I'm taking online courses and doing personal private lessons for kids, coaching with CBA and Swagger Athletics. So I'm staying involved in the game. After baseball, I really want to be a coach and be a counselor to these kids. I know I want, that's my purpose, I feel like, in life. So I want to be consistent, helping people, consistent like this network. You know what I'm saying? Making the all-star teams in the minor leagues, it was like you're playing with best of the best. To get MVP, I was like, bro, I belong, bro. But at the same time, it's all about who they give the opportunity to. Yeah, what I learned in the minor leagues, politics. It's not about who, it's not about what you know, it's who you know. And going through that, it can kill you at times because a guy can have less numbers than you, but more chances than you. So say if I was hitting 300, I'm gonna stay, but if I even twinkle with the 250, I'm gone, quick. It all depends how much money you got in that draft. 10 years down the road, I see myself being like a college baseball coach, helping kids either get drafted or get to a four-year, or just a four-year to finish college to get a degree. I'm gonna push the degree morally on them though, because baseball is only for so long, you know what I'm saying? The degree lasts forever. Why I wanna be a coach? Just to put smiles on people's face, because you know, everybody has a bad day. And you can always help somebody through that bad day. And just being close to them, being a mentor. Because being a coach is like almost being a parent, you know? Trying to guide somebody the right way, make sure they don't get in trouble. No, but outside of baseball, I study in the lab, making slaps. I focus on music outside of baseball because majority of my time is on baseball. So when I need something to ease my mind, I throw on a beat and start freestyling, trying to make something. I really like singing. I was in choir as a kid. At the local middle school I was at. If I would give myself advice when I was younger, I would say, stack chicken and stay in school. That degree gonna last forever. Sports won't. Shout out to Consistent Network for this cut and for this film. Thank you to everybody who made me who I am today. Thank you.